is like love, love, love and music. Let me be sure the volume's up. Hello, 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 everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I am Jay Lee. This is Jay Lee's Corner. This is my review for Catfish Season 7, Episode 18. Okay, it is Thursday. It is Friday Eve because it's 2:30 in the morning, bitches. Yes, y'all know, even though it's warm outside, bitch, it's cold in my apartment because I keep my air on freeze because I refuse to ever be hot. Anyway, so, this episode, you know, I was upset on a couple places. We're going to talk about that a little later, but first things first, if you have not done so already, please take a, I know my neighbor's like, this bitch always loud at night, but whatever. Please take a moment to subscribe to my channel, okay? It takes you just a moment and to be an active subscriber, which means to come and watch my videos, comment here and there, you know what I'm saying? Throw a little like on a little video, you know what I'm saying? Share the video and everything, do all those things. But that is what I call being active, because I am an active YouTuber. Someone commented and told me, you want us to be active subscribers, but you won't respond back to our comments. And I was like, I respond sometimes. I'm like, that must be a new person, because y'all know I get with y'all on the lives, okay? I don't have time sometimes to respond to each and every comment. Y'all know I just, you know, I don't have time sometimes, but I want to y'all to know I still love y'all, but you know what I'm saying, don't come for me no more. Anyway, also do not forget to hit the notification bell. Of course, y'all know this is my hoodie. Worry About the Business That Pays You is on my Teespring website. The link is in my description box below this video and each and every other video. I also have other shirts that's on there and my mug, and I have some more stuff up there. So go ahead and shop, shop, shop. Okay, be supportive. I don't know why I have so much energy right now, but bitch, I'm here for it. Anyway, this episode, the practice is my first review of the night. I'm going to be up until like 5 a.m. So, this episode was Nick and Jasmine. Okay, so Nick met, first of all, Nick is a grown adult man with a 9-year-old daughter and a real goddamn on job. So, the fact that he's on Catfish, I was like, Nick, what are you doing in life? Anyway, you know, he brings up how he met Jasmine on this dating app. Okay, he met her on this dating app. I'm not gonna say it was Plenty of Fish. I'm not gonna say it was Tinder. It was some kind of dating app. Who knows which one it was? He says on her dating app, he saw it was a link or the name to her Snapchat. Okay, so he went to her Snapchat, and then on her Snapchat, he sent her a message. She responded, and then they was chatting back and forth or whatever. And so he said, we would talk via Snapchat. Now, y'all, I have Snapchat, too. I ain't been on my Snapchat in a while, because once they changed the bitch, I couldn't figure it out, and I had time to figure it out. So, I have not been on my Snapchat in a while. But, you know, on Snapchat, it shows you if someone is uploading from their camera roll or someone is uploading something live. So, you can tell if they, like, took a picture or a video 6-7 months ago and they're reposting it. So, he said when she was posting stuff, it was all in real time, which made him feel like, okay, you know what I'm saying? She's really posting things, like, and it's not nobody else posting it, because it was like videos of her doing things. Like, she would say, oh, I'm going to Disney, and then she's in Disney. I'm going to the welfare store. She had the welfare store. But not the welfare store, but you know what I'm saying? Anyway, but again, it was live stuff on YouTube, I mean, on Snapchat. So I'm like, okay, that's a valid reason to think the person's the real person. However, I'm going to tell you something a little bit later. So he then says the reason they kind of hadn't met, like, well, he goes into how she said that she had a lot of anxiety about how she looked or whatever, so that's why they could, like, meet face to face. Because she was, again, she was self-conscious about how she looked. But her Snapchat was her in swimsuits. She was going on trips. She in Disneyland. Like, the Snapchats, the pictures, and it was nothing as if she had any kind of anxiety or any kind of self-consciousness about her. Usually, anyone who is self-conscious about themselves, they don't post nothing about themselves at all, because they're too self-conscious, or they're always posting something at an angle, like, you don't see whatever they're self-conscious about. okay, you know me, I'm out and proud of everything. You know what I'm saying? Everything. She was too, if you ask me. So I don't get how he didn't know, because he's a grown up man with real ass job and grown ass kid, and he ain't get it. But I digress. Anyway, he brings up, well, technically, we've met twice, okay? We've met twice. Said the first time, you know what I'm saying? Because I kept saying, like, I want to talk. And they had only been talking for a total of 5 months. He said she gave me her address, whatever. I went to her apartment, but she only came to the window, and all I saw was her shadow. I mean, what I'm going to say is, that's some fugazi shit. He kept saying the word fugazi or something like that. We say fugazi here in Detroit, and fugazi just means fake as hell. So for me, that was him. It was very fugazi. Anyway, he then said the second, but he said I talked to her through the window, whatever, and it was her voice. Okay, my question was her voice when you was talking to her in person, was it the same voice in the videos? And that part didn't ask him, but wasn't whatever. I'm assuming it was, because he didn't say it was any different. He then said the second time he went over there for Valentine's Day, he had her whole little gift or whatever, and she again said, my anxiety, I can't do this, I can't see you in person, you can't see me, I'm just so subconscious. And so he said they was talking through the door, but again, he could not see her. He then said, but it was her voice. I heard her breathing hard, like having like little anxiety attacks or whatever, so I didn't want to push her. I didn't want to, you know what I'm saying, force anything on her. That's smart. Don't force somebody to do nothing in the beginning. Well, at all. Because that's not... Don't force anyone to do nothing ever. Okay? He then said she blindfolded me. She made me turn around. She blindfolded me so I could not see her. She then turned me around and held my hands and kissed me on the lips. First of all, I'm not kissing nobody. I'm not letting nobody blindfold me that I've never seen before. Because if you blindfold me and I've never seen before, how can I describe my rapist? Okay, you know what I'm saying? This is the truth be told, you know. But how do you let a person blindfold you and kiss you? What if her whole mouth got all the herpes sores? Like, what if her whole mouth got all the little dirty rats on it? What if her whole mouth was just blistered up? What if her whole mouth been out here dick sucking all day? You can't be letting people kiss you on the mouth because they could be dick sucking all damn day. Anyway, we had that whole thing. Just weird, 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 weird. So he brings up how he bought her Demi Lovato tickets and he sent them to her and she went to the concert, and how she Snapchatted her at the concert. However, she never showed herself at the concert. So that's trick number one, which you should know, she ain't the right person. Because if you on Snapchat any other day showing things you do, showing I'm here, I'm there, I'm every fucking where, why wouldn't she show herself at the Demi Lovato concert? All it was a picture of her dressed at home saying thanks for the tickets. And the thanks for the tickets was like written out, you know what I'm saying, the little caption or whatever. I'm not getting some bullshit afoot. He also brings up how he sent her about $600 to get her car fixed. Anyway, so Neve and Max, you know, of course, go do their investigating or whatever. And you know what I'm saying? They find, like, whatever app or whatever. They see some app where it's a guy who I guess was on The Real World and other MTV shows. He was, like, one of her, like, friends on there or whatever. So, of course, they message him. They're like, that's just a little coincidence. And then they look for her photos, like, on the little thing that the photos at. And they find it hit. Her Instagram, and the Instagram takes them to the page of someone called Jocelyn, not Jasmine, Jocelyn, and it was put with like a whole bunch of A's and S's and stuff. It was real, real weird. Anyway, so but it's the girl in the photos that he's showing, but again, the names are different or whatever. So you know, they of course message her, she calls back, then she FaceTimes them, and then they're like, are you talking to somebody named Nick? And she's like, no. You have a son? You know, this Nick is talking to this girl who said her name is Jasmine. She, you know, was photos and videos of you on her Snapchat, is of you and your son, like in a pool or whatever. And she's like, I remember that. She's like, no, that's my nephew. Like, no. So I'm like, well, damn, someone knows her enough to be able to get her live doing stuff and is recording as if they're her. I'm like, so that means it got to be somebody in her family or something, because who's around her enough to record her to put on their own snaps, okay? Because again, it's live snaps. That's what it is. Anyway, you know, of course she does the videos, and I'm Jocelyn. I don't know you. You're getting catfish. I'm saying cat is on you, fish. So then the MTV dude calls back, and then he says, well, I don't know anyone named Jasmine or whatever. And they're like, well, this app that you both are on, he's like, well, I had that app before. I don't use it. I haven't used it in a while. And it could be that we have this, we've exchanged phone numbers, so we could be phone contacts, and that can be how I'm also listening on this app thing that she has. So they give him the phone number they have for her, and he looks it up, of course, in his phone to see if he has the phone number. And sure enough, he does. But he has it at some girl named, I think, Leilani or something like that. And he said, well, yeah, oh, I think I met her like on Instagram or something. She was kind of pretty or whatever. She sent me a DM. We talked on, we exchanged numbers, and we texted back and forth, but I never met her. I didn't meet her. I didn't send her no money, whatever. So basically, it's not this person's first time catfishing somebody, because again, it's two different people. It's just different, okay? So she's a professional catfish. If you catfish two people, you're professional. Anyway, so they go to the apartment that Nick said he met her at. Just kind of stake it out and see. Because they asked him, did you ever think about, like, just staking out the apartment to see her? And he said, well, one time I thought about it or whatever. And so I ordered a pizza, had the pizza delivered there. And the pizza then went knock on the door, but no one ever came to the door, so I didn't see her. I would have sat outside the damn apartment for, like, 2 days. I would have sat there. It just sat there, okay? You sit there, you wait. Because they got to come in one day or the other. And you go on, like, a Thursday, a Friday, or a Saturday, okay? Because people always leave the house on them day. Like, you might not, no matter of fact, no, on Monday. Because you got to have a job, and you just wait. You take a whole day, you wait to see who comes out that apartment, okay? That's what I would do. Anyway, if I had time. Because right now, I wouldn't have time. I would send someone else to do it for me, okay? Because you got to work with friends to get people and figure out what they're doing. Okay? Yeah, it'd be like Inspector Gadget. So, they get to this apartment, and they like, this looks like a death trap. And it did look like a goddamn gone death trap. I mean, I think I've been to somewhere like that before, back in my day. That'll be a story time for the day. The building wasn't that bad, but the building looked as if they were rebuilding it, or like it was abandoned. It was weird. And so, because it was like on one side, it was apartments, but on the side where he said she lives, like, it was, not even tore down, like it was broken down to the bare bones of the structure, like they was rebuilding it basically. And they're like, this is crazy, what's going on here? So they asked the neighbors, and they would say, oh, like the place burned down, and so it's being rebuilt, and it just happened recently, within the past like week or so, whatever. So that's crazy. The apartment where she lived, they can't even stake it out and see who she is, because it ain't there no more. Crazy, crazy, crazy. So they then just go back to him. They call Jasmine and say, hey, Jasmine, you're busted, okay? We know you're not Jasmine because we'll put the person in the photo because we talked to her. What's your name? Nicole. Okay, Nicole. So you know what I'm saying? Can you meet up with Nick? He wants to meet you in real life. This is Neve or whatever. Can we do this? At first, I can't do this. I can't. And then they convince her, well, no, he knows you are and who you say you are. He's okay with that. He just wants to meet you. So then she agrees. Okay. This is where I get frustrated, okay? So they get to the girl's house. She gives them the address. They get there. So Neve goes to the door, and she cracks the door, okay? And she's already having a bit of a panic attack. So Neve has to go in to kind of calm her down and to say, I'll come in. I can talk to you, because they don't show who she is. I'm coming, because he's trying to calm her down. I'm going to come in, and then we can walk out together, okay? Just calm down, calm down, calm down. Take a breath. Take a breath. Take a breath. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? He coaxed her ass to come outside after she's had this whole little panic attack or whatever. Look, bitch. The minute I seen them dirty ass Ugg boots and some goddamn leggings and a thick ass thigh, I was pissed the fuck off, bitch. I said, why I gotta be a big bitch? Not only a big bitch, why I gotta be a big African American bitch? I'm like, look, this is the bullshit that be pissing the bitch off, okay? I'm like, look, I am very upset because as I see that dirty ass Ugg boot and them goddamn leggings, them thick ass thighs, I'm like, it's a big girl. Okay, it's a big girl. I'm like, why do plus size people be on here making me look bad, bitch? Why you doing that to me, bitch? You know what I'm saying? It angers me every time I'm watching goddamn Catfish and the person catfishing is a big person. Look, bitch. Just stop doing that shit, bruh. It pissed me the fuck off, okay? I'm like, this is some bullshit if I ever seen it, okay? She come outside, okay? She not an ugly girl, okay? She's a big girl. Y'all know I am a big girl. I am a big bitch, and I know that about myself. And you can't speak, you know, you, as fucking I even say, you can't get at me with my own teeth. Bitch, yes, I'm big. I'm not gonna, it makes me so pissed off that people be on Catfish and be big and be like, well, I did this because people won't like me before I look. Well, bitch, would bitch change? If you are not happy with how you look, bitch, change that shit, okay? All day, every goddamn day. So, got me mad, okay? Anyway, so, she come out, she talking, she's having a whole anxiety. I'm still mad because the bitch is in Ugg boots and leggings and a goddamn sweater. And I'm like, oh, you're going to have a proper big bitch attire on? So, you couldn't have on nothing else but that. Like, oh, this made me so mad. Anyway, she says, I just don't want people to think I'm a malicious person or whatever. But I feel like you would not have looked at me if I looked like myself. Like, if I didn't look like the picture, the girl in the picture, you would not have talked to me. What that means, he ain't supposed to talk to you, bitch. You have, look, you big bitches, and I'm a big bitch too. I'm going to quote myself, we cannot try to trick people into talking to us. I have never in my fucking life tricked someone to talk to me. Because guess what? If you don't like me for me, bitch, I don't want you to be with me. Okay? Because it is plenty of, it's trust and believe. It is plenty of people who like big people. It's plenty of people who like plus-ass people. It's plenty of people who don't like skin. It's people have a preference. You can't be out here tricking people like I'm gonna make you think I look like her to make you like me, and then once you see me and I don't look like her, can you still like me? Because I knew you wouldn't like me if you knew what I look like, but now you should like me because we talk when we care for each other. No, bitch, I care for the person I was looking at, okay? That ain't you. Because if I'm in this, I feel like it is okay to not be attracted to someone if that ain't your fucking type. It is nothing wrong with not being attracted to someone who isn't your type. That's not wrong, okay? It's not. The fuck? When she said, I just knew you would not like me if you knew what I look like. Well, then he ain't the one for you, ma. Okay, bitch. I was like, this effort right here. She then said, you know, since sometimes I don't feel good about myself. And of course, I can relate to that. I've had moments in my past where one day I was like, bitch, I don't like myself. But I was like, you know what, bitch? No, you love yourself. And I am okay. I've been okay with me for a long ass time. And you have to be okay with yourself. But she said, at times, I do not feel good about myself. So she already has inner issues in her. So my thing is, if you don't feel good about yourself, you should not even be out here trying to fucking date no goddamn body. Because you still fucked up in this goddamn system. Anyway, she gets all, oh God, I can't do this. I have to go back in the house. And then she goes back in the goddamn house. And she's in the house like, I ruined someone's life. I'm a horrible person. You're not a horrible person. You have not ruined anyone's life. What you need to do is get your own emotions together. Get yourself fixed first, bitch. Because even if he did like you, you still too broken to date anybody. Okay? Too goddamn broken, bitch. Anyway, you know, so they leave. Because she done left them outside. Because she can't do it. Okay? So they go back to the house. They do have him tell his cousin, like, what happened or whatever. How he basically been lying. He like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? She blindfolded me one day. I didn't see her. And she kissed me. His cousin like, the fuck is wrong with you, bro? You stupid. Like, who does that? You didn't say no. He's like, no, I just liked her or whatever. You know, a dumb old move. Anyway, and the cousin was laughing. We see that whole thing. We then see them two meet up. And, you know, she like, you know what I'm saying? I know I don't have any children. She then said the way I was able to post snaps was I had two phones. I got two phones. For a long time, that song, Two Phones, I thought the things that I had two phones, one for the something and one for the Lord. What did I think it said? Yeah, I think one for the plug. I thought it said one for the plug, one for the Lord. I was very confused. Anyway, she said I had two phones. So I would have one phone playing the girl's snaps. and I would record it on my second phone as a live thing. So as she's live on her thing, I'm recording her. And so that way it looks as if it's me, you know, it's my thing. And I'm like, bitch. But what I was going to say earlier was, if you talk to somebody via Snapchat and they're posting things via Snapchat, bitch, you have to say, I need to post a picture of yourself right now holding your license, holding a black spoon, bitch, a black spoon. I need you to hold some tropical fruit punch Kool-Aid packets up, and I need you to put your hair in two ponytails. I need a purple bow in this hair and a red bow in this hair. Make them post some shit that only they would have to do live if it's them. Not only that, make them say, you know what I'm saying, Jack be nimble, Jack be quick, Jack jump over the candlestick. Hey, Jay Lee, I noticed you and I noticed me. Now let's go to the ballet. Like, make them do something that, you know what I'm saying, do just something, bitch, okay? I'm like, I just can't stand this bullshit. Anyway, so that's how she recorded stuff on the two phones or whatnot. You know, they say, well, what about the Demi Lovato concert? Did you go? She's like, yeah. Did she have fun? She was like, yeah. He like, you know, well, how long was you gonna have this go on? Like, I gave you some stuff or whatever. She do say, well, I didn't ask you for anything. I told you in the beginning that I did not want gifts at all. I did not want to get anything from you. But you just said here, and you told me I ain't have to pay you back, even though I told you I would. He said, no, I'm not saying pay me back. I just wonder how long was you gonna go with this. She brings up how, you know what I'm saying, you're a great guy. You know, I'm very, very sorry that I did this. She did seem very, 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 very sorry. Okay, she did seem very, very, very apologetic. I can say that. She was crying, all this other bullshit or whatever. You know what I'm saying? He says, you know, was it real? Was it genuine? She says, yes, it was. I said, do he like her? He want to be with her? What's going on here, Nick? What you doing? You know what I'm saying? She then says, you know, I haven't been right since my dad died. You know, my dad passed away. I gained a lot of weight. I say to myself, I made a profile, and things kind of spiral from there. Y'all know my father passed away too, you know what I'm saying, 3 years ago, almost 4 years ago. And, you know, losing a parent will have you fucked up, okay? It will have you absolutely fucked in the mind. But I still feel like you can't use that as a reason that you then go and deceive someone else. If you was at home eating and getting bigger, that's your plight to deal with. We get it, because when my dad died, bitch, you know what I'm saying, it was horrific. You know what I'm saying? You are in a complete and utter state of disbelief, a zombie, like haze, like nothing is even real. So I can completely get that, but I still feel like you can't use that as a reason to hurt someone else or to deceive someone else. Like, I don't get that, but whatever. Anyway, you know, he does say, like, look, I completely get it. Like, we can still be friends and talk, you know what I'm saying, here and there, whatever, that's fine. And that's kind of how they end it. You know, they talk to them 3 months later. You know, he says how they do friendly text each other, how they're not, like, kicking or nothing like that, and how he's just trying to be supportive about her feeling better about herself. They show her, she looks 100% better. She looks happy, bitch, she looked like she was a whole different person. And I'm like, did she catfish us too? Like, did she catfish the whole situation? She, for how sad and depressed and anxiety ridden that she was in those moments, she was like a whole completely different person. So I'm like, did she trick us to make us feel bad? Did she? I don't know. Anyway, you know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, that's how it went off. Look, big people of my nature, okay? People of my own earth, okay? Stop thinking that you have to trick someone into loving you. If someone can't love you for the way you are, they don't need to be with you, okay? And if you're not happy with how you are built, bitch, fix it, okay? And if you are happy with how you built, you know what I'm saying, live fucking life, but don't be out. If I see another big bitch on Catfish, I'm going off on Neve, Max, and everybody over there at MTV, okay? Because the bullshit needs to stop. Okay, the bitch came out in dirty Ugg boots and some goddamn leggings. I say, with some thick ass thighs. I say, bitch, this is some bullshit here, okay, bitch? No, don't do that, okay? Just don't do that. Anyway, I'm all set. I'm all done. The comment code for this video, y'all know, put a comment code in the comment box below. Put thick thighs, okay? Put thick thighs. Put blindfolded kisses. So either thick thighs blindfolded kisses or broken cars. Pick one of them and I'm done. Okay. Peace.